they put these white lines on the road like you're not supposed to drive there or something, but they don't actually put anything there to prevent you from driving on them, like fucking nails or anything. Trooper, yo, my plans for today got all effed up because I had to stay at work last night until 5:15 in the morning. What type of shit is this? Overtime. I don't know if you know this, but in Nevada, if you work more than 8 hours in a day, it's overtime. It's also 40 hours a week, but it's 8 hours a day as well. But whatever. Look, I don't want overtime, okay? I wanted to go to sleep at 4, get up at 10, edit the vlog, and go play poker today. But instead, I go to sleep at 6 after only sleeping 5 hours the night before. And now it's 1:30 in the afternoon. I'm going to edit the vlog, and I just don't have enough assets. Which time is the asset? And I don't have enough time. So, damn it. I'm going to go edit the vlog and not worry about poker. I have to go deal at 8 o'clock. Let's just see how it works out. But yeah, here we go. So I ran short on time today because of the fact, what the fuck is up with these fucking lights? Yo, I ran out of time today because of the fact that I was at work until 5:15 in the morning, and by the time I go home and go to sleep and then edit the vlog today, there's no time left, and I'm also running out of sun, which really fucking blows. But I thought I would do a Q&A again, so let's check into Twitter and Facebook, where I ask you guys to ask me questions. So, why don't I ever go through a drive-thru at Starbucks? Well, I do go through a drive-thru at Starbucks, but very seldom, and there's a couple of reasons why. Reason number one would be that I want to put my own cream and sugar, because they never put the right amount of cream, ever. It doesn't happen. So I want to do it. You know what I mean? But I have gone through a drive-thru when I ordered a nice coffee before, because I usually get a grande iced coffee with 2 pumps of vanilla and 2%. So yeah. Why do I place my shoes on the kitchen counter? Didn't you used to troll me? Just tell me the truth. Did you used to make troll comments in the thread on 2 plus 2? Because I really think you did, but I don't know. Maybe you did it. Maybe I'm confusing you with somebody else, but I'm going to tell you why I put the shoes on the kitchen counter. First of all, I don't consider that a kitchen counter. I consider that a, just a place to put my shoes. I don't know what to tell you except that the place where I'm staying at the moment, I don't treat it like a real home or like I would at a normal place. So, what is this security bitch? She better not come up here and say nothing to me. Did I pay to go to dealer school? No, I never went to dealer school, nor did I pay to go to dealer school, because you don't have to go to dealer school. All you gotta do is know how to deal and pass an audition to get a job. And I was just self-taught. I did have a friend here in Vegas who's a dealer give me some pointers one night. We went to Orleans and got an extra setup and a rack of blue, and she gave me some pointers on some things that I was doing wrong, because obviously if you're self-taught, you're going to have a couple little bad habits like rolling the deck and little things like that. But nah, no dealer school. I'm running out of light and I'm just trying to go fast. If I don't get to your question, we'll do this again sometime, I'm sure of it. Will I ever devote a blog post to my social life outside of poker? The vlog is about my life every single day. So, social life outside of poker? I mean, if you mean go to a bar or some shit like that, I don't do that. It's not something I've ever done. If you're asking about the ladies, don't worry, I'm working on that. Best three bars, buffets, and burgers? No clue on bar? Buffet, I mean, the Wynn is really good. Caesar's I heard was good, but I don't really know. I've never been there. Cosmo I've heard is the best buffet. But burger, I mean, I love Shake Shack. If you're talking about gourmet burgers, like higher priced burgers, I don't really do those either, because I don't really care for that very much. So, but I heard burger at Planet Hollywood is pretty good. Do I ever get my car's oil changed? Yeah. Yeah, I get my car oil changed. That's a crazy question, Jeff. Playing at Harrah's Poker Rooms for a buffet, did I think the games were better? PH is a Harrah's Poker Room. You didn't know that? Planet Hollywood is owned by Caesars. And no, the games at Harrah's are definitely not as good as Planet Hollywood. Neither are Caesars and neither are anywhere else for that matter because they have the best game. Oh, Ejax, I'm going to answer your question. I don't know what it is yet. What is my name? What is my quest? What is the airspeed of an unladen swallow? All right, you know what? I changed my mind, Ejax. I'm not answering that shit. My name is Tim. I think you know that, though. Quest, I don't know, for truth and freedom. And I don't know what an unladen swallow is, but it sounds perverted. Jason Redding, what's been my best moment since moving to Vegas? Reading this question, of course. Poker Hero, will I deal at the WSOP? No. Snap answered no. I don't want to do that. What is that security bitch doing? Yo. But, yeah, I can still play. I can play everything in Vegas I want to play except for table games at the link, including poker. And I can't play machines with progressive jackpots at any Caesars properties. I wouldn't play that in the first place. So, moving right along to Facebook. All right, so we're running out of light, but the light from the phone seems to be working. But the fucking security lady wants me to get out of here, so I'm going to get out of here. But I'm going to answer a couple more questions first. Scott Cooper want to know, fuck you? Question mark, no, Scott. Because I love the ladies, you know what I'm saying? I mean, unless you're a lady, because I don't really know, because it's 2016. And all I know is that prism on your face. Whoa, did I say that out loud? Whoa, calm down. Everybody calm down. I didn't say the P word. Prism vagina. Let's answer an intelligent question. All right, John, this is a pretty good question because would you still move to Vegas today considering how the last year and a half has gone with the same bankroll you started with? Basically, I'm talking about just living in Vegas. Do you still enjoy it? Yes, I do. Yes, I would. As a matter of fact, I would like to start over today with the same $2,000 or $2,300 or whatever that I landed here in Vegas with when I came here a year and a half ago. Because the truth is, and a lot of people are going to flame this, and a lot of people are going to think this is ridiculous, a ridiculous statement, but the truth of the matter is, knowing and understanding today what I should have known and understood a year and a half ago. If you gave me $2,000 right now and 24 hours a day, in other words, not obligated to go to the link, I would still make the vlogs, especially if I didn't make the vlogs. But even making the vlogs, I don't believe I would go broke. I mean, unless I ran really, really shitty. I believe I would have a much, much better chance of not going broke because I would short stack 1-2 for $100, and I would do it 12 hours a day, 7 days a week, until I had a real role. Am I going to take $2,000 or $3,000 right now and quit the link and go for that? No, because there are a couple of things that are different. I mean, I also now know how difficult it is to land a job in Vegas. It's not easy. There are too many other people looking for a job, and you got to know somebody. And not only that, every job that I've tried to get, it took a couple of months. It took me 2 months of relentlessly applying for jobs in restaurants before I finally got something. So yes, I would definitely do it again. I would do it again knowing the way that everything has gone, because the way that everything has gone has helped facilitate a growth in me as a person. So through adversity, there is redemption. Is that how it goes? That's how the Killswitch would say it and Gage song goes, but I don't know how the real saying goes, but you know what I'm saying? I don't even know if you can still see me. Well, actually, part of the other question before was, would I play the casino employees tournament? You know what? There's a chance that I might would play that because it has a fast structure, and I like fast structures. It's 565. Who knows? You never know. But that's going to have to do for today. That is the end of Q&A for today because I got shit to do. It's 6:10, and I got to take my ass to work at the link. I'll try to get back to some of those questions another time. We could do another Q&A, but for right now, that's the end of it. Let me just go ahead and remind you right now, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss anything, leave a comment below and tell your friends about these shits so they can watch them too. and I'll see you next time. Is this bitch coming over here to say something? Because if she is...